In this video, I explain you forced circulation thermostat cooling system. So in this video, I explain the construction, working of thermostat cooling systems and comparisons with the thermosiphon cooling system by using this animation. So first we understand the construction of forced circulation thermostat cooling system. So this is the cylinder. Okay. This is a four cylinder engine, and outside of the engine cylinder there is a water jacket is provided. Okay, so this is the outer part of the engine, and this is known as the water jacket is provided surrounding of the cylinders, and this water jacket is completely filled with the water. This water temperature is heated, then it is supplied to the radiator for the cooling purpose. This is known as upper hose connection, and this is the lower hose connections. And this is the completely radiators. In a radiator, it is known as upper tank. This part is known as the lower tank. In a radiator, fin is provided, and it is also completely filled with the water. And in upper side, the water filling pot is provided for filling the water. And here the fan is provided for air circulations from the radiator. Here one pump is provided. In a thermosiphon system, pump is not provided. It is a natural circulations. But here we studying the forced circulation. Why it is forced circulation? Because we use the pump. That's why it is known as the forced circulation system. And here another name is a thermostat. So thermostat is a one type of the device. Okay, which regulate the flow of water. Okay, its name is a thermostat, means it start the flow of water according to condition of the thermal condition. Thermo means it is related with heat. Okay, so when this water temperature is reaches up to certain conditions, okay, suppose we set the 85 degree. Okay, so when this water jacket temperature is reached 85 degree, at that time the thermostat is open and the water is supplied to the radiators. Otherwise, below 85 degree, thermostat is closed. Okay, means water is only circulated in water jacket. Okay, not in this part of the radiators. So this is the function of thermostats, and this thermostat is also connected with this lower hose pipe. So it is known as the bypass lines. So this is construction is over. Next we move towards the working. Before moving ahead, I request to like the video and subscribe the channel for watching the more video related to mechanical engineering, and also visit the playlist for the various video. Now before moving ahead on the working, we compare the thermosiphon and the thermostat cooling systems. Okay, so as we know that natural circulation cooling, means thermosiphon is the natural circulation, means in a thermosiphon system we not use the pump. In a thermostat, the forced circulation is there, so we use the pump. Okay, so it's depend on the atmospheric temperature. In a thermosiphon, it is naturally depend on the atmospheric temperatures, but the thermostat system is not depend on the atmospheric temperatures. The circulation of water is established only when the engine become hot. Okay, so it is about the thermosiphon system. In thermosiphon system, the water temperature is increased, means its density is increased, and this hot water is moving in this upper part of the water jacket in a thermosiphon system, and the cold water is coming in a lower direction because it have a higher density. So the when the engine is hot, at that time water circulation is start in a thermosiphon system. Okay, now in a winter, atmospheric temperature is low. Okay, so in a winter atmosphere air temperature is low, and hence more heat transfer takes place, so there is a chances of overcooling. So here we are also talking about thermosiphon system. Okay, so atmosphere temperature is lower during winter, like it is a 15-20 degree. In a summer seasons, the temperature is higher, up to 35 and 40 degree. Okay, so at that time during winter, what happened, that is overcooling is done, and when the overcooling is done in a thermosiphon system, that means our thermal efficiency is reduced. Okay, so our efficiency is reduced. While during summer, what happened, there is a chances of overheatings, because in a summer seasons the 40 degree temperatures, so atmosphere air are not able to completely remove the heat from the radiators. Okay, so that is a overheatings of the engine is there. So due to less temperature difference of cooling waters and atmospheric air temperatures, Okay, so it's the overheating. So that is the vice versa conditions in a thermosiphon system during the different atmosphere conditions. Okay, so avoid this type of the disadvantages of the thermosiphon systems, that is the overheatings and the overcooling during the different seasons, so that forced circulation thermostat cooling system is invented. So even in simple forced circulation cooling system, okay, now here the comparison is over of the thermosiphons and we are talking about the forced circulation thermostat cooling system. Okay, now even in a simple forced circulation cooling system, as the pump is start, okay, when we start this pump, then what happen, it will start the circulating the cold water to the cylinders and it absorb the heat at a faster rate from the cylinder walls, and due to the larger temperature difference is created. As the result, the engine take more time to warm up to desired levels of the temperature, particularly in a cold weather. Means during winter seasons, already atmosphere temperature is lower and this pump is start, the forced circulation is start. So engines are not warm up quickly, okay. And the engine is not warm up quickly, then we lost the thermal efficiency, okay. So to avoid this type of the losses, or a losses like means the more time to warm up, okay. So we need to quick warm up. That why here the thermostat is put it. In a thermostat cooling system, thermostat is used to maintain the predefined minimum water temperature around the engine cylinder. Therefore, no cold starting problem during the cold weather. Okay. So during the cold weather, no starting problems. Means here we putting the thermostat in a upper hose pipe connections. What is its functions? It is used to maintain predefined minimum water temperature around the engine. Means this water temperature is achieved up to certain degree, means generally it is attained to 85 degree centigrade. At that time this valve is open and this thermostat is open, then after the water is start to circulate from the water jacket to the radiator. Otherwise the water is only circulate in this part. So it is up to the pump, cylinders and water jacket. It is not going to the radiators. Okay. So when the 85 degree temperature of this water jacket is achieved, at that time the thermostat is open and it start to supply the water to the radiators. Okay. So we avoid the cold starting problems during the cold weather. Now how the thermostat is open and close depending upon this temperature of this water jacket, that is 85 degree. Okay. So that we understand in this video. The thermostat cooling system is consist of the pump. So here it is the pump, this is the radiators, this is the thermostat and the fan as shown in this figure. The function of pump is to circulate the water through the water jacket to remove the heat from the engine through the radiators, where it is cooled by the flow of air over the radiators. Means function of the pump is to supply the water from this radiator to the cylinders. And this water is absorb the heat from the cylinders and supply this heat to the radiators, and in these radiators the water heat is supplied to the air. The thermostat is a temperature operated valve. Okay, so as I earlier discussed, it is the temperature operated valve. When the certain temperature is achieved, then its valve is open and it is fitted in upper hose connection. It prevents the circulation of water below certain temperatures, usually up to 85 degree centigrade, through the radiator, so that water in the jacket get heated up quickly. Means this valve is open, at that time the water jacket temperature is achieved at the 85 degree centigrade. So now how this thermostat valve is open and closed? Okay. So thermostat valve consists of a thin copper tube, bellows particularly fitted with a volatile liquid, and volatile liquid is ether and methyl alcohol as shown in this figure. So this is the figures of the thermostat. Okay, so from this side water is enter from the jacket, means 85 degree centigrade water is come here. Okay, and this is the bellow filled with volatile liquid, means in this bellow the volatile liquid is filled. Which is the volatile liquid? It is ether or methyl alcohols. And this another end of the bellow is connected with the valve. Okay, and this is the outer body. On this outer body, here the valve seat is provided. Valve seat means the valve is seat on the this place, it is known as the valve seat. Then after this valve is open, at that time the water from thermostat is supplied to the radiators, And here the relief valve is provided, or it is also known as the bypass. Okay, so this volatile liquid is evaporated at certain temperatures, means the liquid is inside this bellows, it is evaporated at certain temperatures. During warm up periods, means warm up means during starting of the engine from the cold, thermostat valve is remains closed and engine is running, the water being pump rise and the pressures causes the pressure relief valve to open, means we are continuously, pump is continuously work, okay, and this thermostat valve is closed. Here you see this is the valve is closed because this water temperatures of the water jacket is not reached to 85, that's why this valve is closed, and the pump is continuously supplying the water to the cylinder jacket or water jackets, okay. Then what happened, the pressure inside the water jacket is increased, that's why we put the one relief valve or a bypass valve, okay. So when the pressure is increased, the relief valve is opens and water is supplied to the bypass valve, okay, bypass valve to the lower hose connection system. So pump is circulate water through the water jacket only. The water does not pass through the radiators, hence the engine cooling does not take place. Means when the water temperature is below 85 degree centigrade, this valve is closed and the water is not supplied to the radiators. So where the water is circulate, water does not pass the radiator, hence the engine cooling does not take place. So it is only in the water jacket and a pump system. Now when the water temperature is reaches 85 degree centigrade, then what happen, we need to open this valve. So how it is to open? So when the engine is reached at a normal operating temperature, and operating temperature is says 85 degree centigrade, the volatile liquid in the thermostat valve is vaporized, means in this bellow volatile liquid is there, it start to vaporize and thus creating enough pressure inside the bellow to expand and lift the valve as shown in this figure, okay. So when this liquid inside this bellows is vaporized, at that time what happen, it expands and the apply some pressures, so this valve is moving in upper directions, okay. So here you see this is a valve seat and the valve, that is a certain space. So water is start to transfer from the water jacket to this radiator, hence the thermostat valve is open and the water pressure falls, relief valve is closed, okay, means when this valve is open, the pressure is start to reduce inside the water jacket, so water pressure is falls, relief valve is closed, hence the water circulated through radiators and engine cooling comes in action. This type of the cooling system is used for automobiles as well as the standby diesel power plants up to 200 kilowatt. In a case of large diesel power plant, this system is used with a cooling tower instance of the radiators. So in a large plant instance of the radiators, the cooling tower is provided. Thank you for watching this video. If you learned, then like the video, subscribe the channels, comment on the video and share with your friend.